Cryptoeconomics aims to understand virtual decision-making by unknown, untrusting peers. If that's too abstract for you, think Bitcoin. Several different people are trying to come to agreement on a history of transactions. They're all incentivized to exploit any possibilities which might bring them more profit. Satoshi Nakamoto's goal in designing Bitcoin, then, is to remove any possibilities of actors unfairly getting more profit than they deserve, however they choose to define deserve. One could say a goal of Bitcoin would be to ensure actors get rewards proportional to the amount of computational power they put into the network. We know from our previous course, Bitcoin and Cryptocurrencies, that there are several ways to extract profit maliciously due to incentive misalignments. To prevent inequitable behavior, it's necessary to determine how to construct an ecosystem in which actors are incentivized to do things which help the greater good, and in which they can make these decisions securely. Let's break down how decisions are made, and let's start with time. Time is distinguished by three things: the past, present, and future. In every moment, changes are happening because people are making decisions. In the physical world, as mentioned in the intro, these decisions permanently change the world. To replicate this in the virtual world, we first need to ensure that good changes are made, and then make these changes permanent. Because this is a virtual world, every construction to make these all possible will be virtual. So what tools do we have to accomplish this? Cryptography, first and foremost, is a tool used to secure information to make sure that decisions are not modified once made. Every time an actor makes a decision in a decentralized network, they secure that decision with cryptography. Examples include cryptographic signatures for authentication and hashes for immutability. Hence, cryptography is used to secure the past. Economics, on the other hand, informs us how to design our system to ensure that actors make decisions in line with the goals of the greater good. By understanding the incentives of each actor, it's possible to reduce the prevalence of game theoretical attacks. Examples include the block reward in Bitcoin and the cost of mining to deter Sybil attacks. In other words, economics is used to secure the future. By combining these two perspectives, we can do some fascinating things. Before we talk about those things, however, we want to go over some basic cryptographic and economic primitives, or building blocks, which we will then use to analyze and construct some examples of protocols.